We'll take a question on the previous class concept, and then we'll start the class, the new concept. Okay? Let us see whether you are well versed with this. Give it back. There is this rod. Stop talking. There is this rod, okay? The rod mass is capital M and the length is L, okay? There is another mass, a point mass that is fixed at the end of the rod with mass small m. Got it? You are giving somehow this rod acquires some angular velocity, alright? By the way, the rod is free to rotate about this axis, okay? Fine, so it can swing like this in a vertical plane, fine? So, you are giving it with some angular velocity so that one end of the rod acquires a velocity V0, okay? You need to find out what is the value of V0 so that the rod just becomes horizontal. Got it?
So the masses are different, right? That small m.
Small m, capital M. We have done the concept of energy, right?
Yes,
Okay, the hint is you have to write down this work with the theorem W is equal to U2 plus K2 minus U1 plus K1. So the work done is zero. Stop talking. U2 plus K2 will be equal to U1 plus K1 as work done is zero.
So but there is displacement.
Is work done zero or not? Which force will do work?
Minus mg.
See, mg is doing work, no doubt about that. But for mg, you are considering potential energy. If you are considering potential energy for a force, you don't need to find the work done for that force. Okay? And there are forces from the hinge, but the point of application doesn't move of the hinge. So the work done by the hinge forces is zero. So between this position and that position, apply this theorem.
The expressions when you are doing. Yes.
Another hint is the rod plus small m can be treated as a single rigid body. Assume this line to be zero potential energy. It will be better than. This line is what? U2. U2 is zero, let us say. Okay? Fine. U2 is 0. What about K2?
0.
K2 is also 0. It just goes to that position. Fine. So both U2 and K2 are 0. Now, let's try to write down the kinetic energy of this rod along with this mass. Fine. So you can write down the kinetic energy in different ways. Alright. K1, you can write it as half moment of inertia of the rod about the fixed axis into omega square plus half m into V naught square. So you have written kinetic energy of the rod plus kinetic energy of the mass. You are writing it separately. Okay. And moment of inertia about the fixed axis is how much? ML square by 3. So half m L square by 3. Omega is what? V naught by L. Okay, so this is the kinetic energy. Another way to write the kinetic energy is to find the moment of inertia about this fixed axis for the entire rigid body. For the entire rigid body, moment of inertia will be what? ML square by 3 plus small m into L square. So kinetic energy will be half total moment of inertia, which is ML square by 3 plus ML square into omega square. This will be the total kinetic energy, alright? This is K1. What about U1? U potential energy, it is better to split. Otherwise, you have to find out the center of mass location for the combined system. If you can find out, no problem. The potential energy will be M plus capital M into G into height of the center of mass. Or you can split it into two parts. Potential energy of the rod plus potential energy for the small mass. This will be equal to what? Negative of capital MG L by 2. It is down. The center of mass of the rod is down. Okay? And negative of MG L. Any doubt? This is U1, this is K1, U2 and K2 substitute there, you get the answer. Okay? Any doubts? Okay, I did not know that we have... Can you show the notes what we have done at the end of the last class? We just started the energy, right?
Yeah.
And we have written kinetic energy about the fixed axis as well as rotation plus translation. Okay. Right. So we have just introduced what is the kinetic energy and potential energy of a rigid body. So we can continue solving problems right now. Alright, so we have learned that kinetic energy of a rigid body is half moment of inertia about the fixed axis into omega square. Fine. Which omega? About which axis?
Fixed axis.
About the center of mass. Or the fixed one. Which one? Omega.
Omega is... Yeah,
omega is same for entire rigid body. That is why it is called a rigid body. Fine. If omega of one point is different from other point, it will no longer remain a rigid body. It will distort. Okay. So, this is the kinetic energy. If you are not able to find the fixed axis, no problem. You can write it like this. Half m into vcm square plus half moment of inertia about center of mass into omega square. Two ways you can write the kinetic energy. Both ways you get the same answer for the kinetic energy. Alright? Fine. And potential energy, we have already learned, is mg into height of the center of mass. Okay? And on top of it, you remember the work per energy chapter? Remember, right? Where we have been using W is equal to U2 plus K2 minus U1 plus K1. Fine. Or you can remember it like this also, that U1 plus K1 plus W is equal to U2 plus K2. So you can do some amount of work to increase the initial mechanical energy. But if you're doing the negative work, your initial mechanical energy will reduce to U2 plus K2. Fine. So both ways you can remember, right? So we are going to take few questions now which will test you on these fundamentals. I think there should not be any confusion. We have done a lot of questions in work per energy chapter already. Okay. Now we are going to use work per energy concept for a rigid body. Okay. The methodology is exactly the same. The only difference is the way you write kinetic energy and potential energy. That is the only difference. So keep it simple in your head. It is very easy to complicate. Okay? Alright, so we'll take up a simple scenarios and we'll build on it. There is this rod, chup ho jao, mass M and length L. Okay. This is free to rotate about that axis. You have to find out the angular velocity when it has rotated by an angle of theta. It is rotating in a vertical plane. Okay. Got it?
Yes, sir.
All you have to see where the center of mass is initially and where it is finally. Okay? This is the center of mass. How the center of mass is moving? Like this. It reaches here. It travels vertically a distance of how much? This is L by 2. So this will be?
Sine theta. L by 2 sine
theta. L by 2 sine theta. Got it? So I am going to use work energy theorem between this position and that position. Fine? So step number one, write down W is equal to U2 plus K2 minus U1 plus K1, and then substitute. Work done is zero. Final potential energy is what? Depends what you are taking your initial potential energy. Where should take initial potential energy? Let's take this line as zero potential energy. So my U2 becomes?
Minus.
U1 becomes zero. K1 is also zero. It starts from rest. So U2 will be minus of?
Mg L by 2
sine theta plus kinetic energy will be half. I know there is a fixed axis. So I can directly write half moment of inertia about the fixed axis ML square by 3 into omega square. This is equal to 0. So from here I will get the value of omega. What are you getting omega as?
3g sine theta by L.
This is what you will get omega after it rotates by an angle theta. Okay. Now suppose I ask you after time t how much it will rotate, then what you will do? You have to find angle of rotation after time t. No, I am asking you, don't start solving it. I am asking you how you will solve for angle theta after time t.
D theta by dt.
Omega is d theta by dt?
Yes.
Okay, you write omega as d theta by dt and then bring here 1 by sine theta, 1 by root sine theta d theta you have to integrate now. And that side will be dt. So when you, if you are able to integrate 1 by root sine theta, you will get the answer. Okay? Fine? If I ask you, a similar kind of question we have done when we learned the torque problem, right? Same problem we have done. We got the angular velocity then also. Calculated angular velocity, check whether it is the same thing. Using torque we have calculated. We got alpha and then integrated alpha to get omega. We have written alpha as omega d omega by d theta. You got the same thing, right? We calculated omega after theta becomes 90, right? We got alpha as 3g cos theta by 2l. We got alpha as 3g cos theta. This is what we have got, yes or no? And then alpha is equal to omega d omega by d theta. This will be equal to 3g by 2l cos theta. So theta you go that, theta goes that side. When you integrate, you get omega square by 2 and 3g by 2l sine theta. 2 and 2 will be going and then you get omega as this. So you get the same answer two different ways. Like the way in laws of motion chapter, you get acceleration. From acceleration, you can calculate the velocity, or applying work energy theorem also, you can get the velocity. Same way here as well. Fine. Now you have to find out what will be the reaction force of the hinge. Did we do that?
Yes.
Okay. So quickly I tell you. Let's say this is, these are the two reaction forces. Let's say this is Fy and this is Fx. So Fx will be what? Fx will be equal to m omega square L by 2. and Fy will be equal to m alpha into L by 2, because alpha into L by 2 is the tangential acceleration and omega square L by 2 is radial acceleration.
So why L by 2?
Why not?
L full L.
Center of mass you have to track. Center of mass is at a distance of L by 2. Entire rod behaves as if it is a point mass located at the center of mass. Got it?
So what's the acceleration between the center of mass tangentially? How do you find that?
You have alpha. You have alpha. Right? So alpha into L by 2 will be the tangential acceleration. It moves in a circle, right? With angular acceleration alpha.
Yes.
So alpha into L by 2 is tangential acceleration.
We just differentiate omega.
Differentiate, or you directly have this alpha, no?
I just understand why is it L by 2
is the center of mass. You have to see, net force is equal to mass and acceleration of center of mass.
Yes, sir, but how did we get that G cost?
Using torque equation. We have done this. Torque equal to I alpha.
Oh, yeah, the, yes. Yeah.
Right? The mg is a force. So mg sin theta is perpendicular component. Mg sin theta into L by 2 is I alpha.
Yes.
You get alpha. Okay. Any other doubt? You have done all that. Then we'll learn the torque equation. Is it clear? Okay.